Imagine sending a copy of your latest manuscript to the publishers with the following message. The most important thing in life was life itself, and life is rain. The reasoning is simple. Rain begets vegetation on the earth. Spermatozoa beget offspring in the womb. God, the creator, the source of rain, must therefore be the sperm of creation and the heavenly penis from which it spills. The storm is the orgasm of God. The drops of rain are the words of God. Earth is the womb of creation. With these words, Dr. John Allegro introduced the publisher Hodder and Stoughton Limited on October 23, 1968, to his book, The Sacred Mushroom and the Cross. Dr. Allegro, a brilliant student of Semitic languages at Manchester University, studied Hebrew dialects at Oxford University. In 1953, he was named to an international team formed to decipher the Dead Sea Scrolls, which were discovered in caves above the Dead Sea 6 years earlier. The scrolls, which spanned the period about 100 BC to AD 70, included the oldest known manuscripts of books from the Old Testament. Dr. Allegro's gift for deciphering minute texts was crucial. His book, The Dead Sea Scrolls, was published in 1956 and became a bestseller. In his 1970 book, The Sacred Mushroom and the Cross, Dr. Allegro contended that Judaism and Christianity were products of an ancient cult based on sex and mushrooms. He theorized that Jesus' last words on the cross were not a lament to God, but a paean of praise to the God of the mushroom. Allegro set out to study the connections between the origins of religion and language, and he focused upon the science of words, also called philology. He thought the best way to see into the mind of ancient man was through his writings and the study of his symbols. The study of the relationship between words and the thoughts they expressed is called etymology. Those who study etymology look for the root of the word, the idea which expresses its true meaning. The ancient people who sought to communicate with their God developed a precise, unchanging terminology whose accurate transmission was the sole responsibility of the priest class. Underlying the earliest ancient religious cults was the common theme of fertility and the power of the god. Allegro theorized that these fertility cults were based on the use of the sacred mushroom Amanita Muscaria. According to Allegro, the mushroom was seen as a symbol of God on earth, but use of this sacred plant was only documented in folktales and myths hidden in the form of codes. He said that, quote, "This is the basic origin of the stories of the New Testament. They were a literary device to spread the rites of mushroom worship to the faithful. The stories of the Gospels and Acts were a deliberate hoax. Through studying Sumerian cuneiform texts, which go back to 3500 BC, we can trace the proper names and words used in the Bible back to their original meanings," end quote. Needless to say, this caused outrage in the Christian community. The book was vilified after it was first published in 1970. However, since then, other evidence has come to light in support of many of Allegro's theories. A book published in 2008 by Jan Irvin called The Holy Mushroom, Evidence of Mushrooms in Judeo-Christianity, presented ancient texts that supported Allegro's ideas. One of the texts cited in Irvin's book was a 16th century Christian text that explicitly discusses the holy mushroom. In addition, that same year, Boston University professor Carol A.P. Ruck publicly endorsed the overall thesis of the sacred mushroom and the cross. Since then, other scholars have come out in support of Allegro's work. One of the most important works to make a serious study of Allegro's proposals was Astrotheology and Shamanism, Christianity's Pagan Roots, published in 2006 by Jan Irvin and Andrew Rutajit. This book uses iconic and symbolic evidence to substantiate many of Allegro's claims, and it includes hundreds of references. Allegro's basic thesis is that fertility was of paramount importance to the ancients, and out of this grew the first primitive religion with the first deity, a fertility deity. Because human survival depended upon this deity, it was critical to establish a method of communication with the source of fertility. This led to the development of rituals that could be performed to influence the deity. Ancient peoples believed that the way to communion with God in heaven was through plants, special plants that were the drug herbs whose cultivation and use had been accumulated over centuries of observation and dangerous experimentation. The mushroom became the center of a mystery cult in the Near East, which persisted for thousands of years. From there, it spread into India some 3,500 years ago and also flourished in Siberia and parts of South America. Allegro surmises that the original names of the mushroom became taboo, and this is the reason knowledge of the mushroom cult has been overlooked by historians. Those who had the secret knowledge of these plants were elevated to the privileged chosen ones. Rarely were these secrets committed to writing. They were passed down from priest to initiate orally. However, under some circumstances, such as when the culture of the ancients was threatened or disrupted through war, it became necessary to write down the names of the sacred herbs and plants, how they were used, and what incantations were recited in concert with their use. And under these circumstances, it was necessary to write these matters in an esoteric form that would be comprehended only by those who were initiated with the secret knowledge. Folktales were the literary device that were used to both preserve and spread this occult knowledge. When it became necessary to commit the secret knowledge to writing, much care would be taken to encode the material and conceal the message. This was done by using special names within a document. Allegro says that plant mythology, known for thousands of years over the whole of the ancient world, provided the New Testament cryptographers with their cover. Wordplay was used so that the special secret names of the holy plant could be conveyed to the initiate alone. Allegro proposes that there are at least three levels of understanding involved in the New Testament writings. On the surface are the Greek words along with the adventures of Jesus. And so this is the level where the story of Jesus and his teachings are told. Allegro does not believe there to be much reality in concert with this level of the writings. Beneath the Greek is a Semitic level of understanding, and it is at this level that the word plays are made. The New Testament writers use the old sacred names of the mushroom for this word play. And finally, at the last level are concealed the basic conceptions of the mystery cult. Allegro says that, quote, here is the real stuff of the mystery philosophy, the mystery fertility philosophy. And he goes on to say, for example, to find their parables of the kingdom, the writers made comparisons with objects and activities, which at the surface level of understanding are often really absurd, besides being self-contradictory about the manner and the form of the kingdom's coming. The passage that likens the kingdom to a mustard seed, for example, and then speaks of birds nesting in the branches of the grown plant, has driven the biblical naturalist to distraction, looking for a mustard tree suitable as roosting place for the fowl of the air. They could have saved himself the trouble, Allegro says, since the reference at the lower level is simply a play on the Semitic cardila, mustard, and ardila, mushroom. Furthermore, the whole discussion about the kingdom stems, he says, from a play on the secret mushroom word tabari, read as the Semitic root D-B-R, which means to guide, manage, control. The real meaning of this mystic kingdom, then, according to Allegro, into which the initiate into the mysteries hope to pass. Allegro theorizes that the names and identities of the drug that functioned as the key to heaven, the sacred mushroom, was the fungus recognized today as the Amanita Muscaria or the fly agaric. This mushroom, with all its characteristic red and white spotted cap, has been known from the beginning of history. Inside of this mushroom is a very powerful hallucinatory poison. He says that the ancients marveled at the growth of the mushroom because it grew without seed, appeared very quickly after rain, and disappeared just as quickly after. Its phallic form was a replica of the fertility god, and as the son of God, its drug was a purer form of the god's own spermatozoa. To the ancients, it was God himself manifest on earth. And to the mystic, it was the divinely given means of entering heaven. God had come down in the flesh to show the path to communication with him. The picking of the sacred mushroom was accompanied by many rites and rituals. Certain words had to be uttered, and the time had to coincide before sunrise. The guardian angel had to be invoked, and most importantly, some form of substitution was necessary to atone to the earth who was robbed of her offspring when the mushroom was picked. Allegro bases his theory on his study of ancient languages. He realized that many of the most secret names of the mushroom date back to ancient Sumerian, which is the oldest written language known. It dates from the 4th millennium BC. Allegro discovered that ancient Sumerian provides a bridge between the Indo-European languages of Greek, Latin, and English, and the Semitic group of languages, including Hebrew and Aramaic. With this knowledge and understanding, Allegro was able to decipher the names of gods, mythological characters, classical and biblical, and plant names. From this, he was able to discover their place in the old fertility religions. The understanding of the beginnings of language also helps us to understand the later mystery cults of Judaism, Dionysus, and Christianity. The isolation of the names of the sacred mushroom opened the door to understanding the mystery cults whose members participated in mystic, hallucinatory experiences on the drugs of the mushroom. The controversy associated with Allegro's work has to do with his thesis that the stories in the New Testament about Jesus and his followers were not about Jesus as a man, but about a mushroom. The true meaning is lost to those who have no understanding of ancient languages, he says. Mistranslations abound and much textual corruption occurred in the names and translations that were added by those who were unfamiliar with the original language that would have been used by Jesus and his disciples. According to Allegro, these aberrations of proper names are of critical importance because they provide us with a clue to the nature of original Christianity. He says, quote, concealed within are secret names for the sacred fungus, the Christian church's Christ. The deliberately deceptive nature of their mistranslation put the lie to the whole of the cover story of the man Jesus and his activities. Once the ruse is penetrated, then research can go ahead fast with fitting the Christian phenomenon more firmly into the cultic patterns of the ancient Near East, end quote. More important than the stories about biblical figures, he says, is the importance of the myths in which the names are found. Allegro believes the real relevance of these names is found in the age-old cult of the sacred mushroom. He says that the original cult of Christianity was driven underground by the combined efforts of the Roman, Jewish, and ecclesiastical authorities who crushed anything they considered heretical. According to Allegro, the earliest primitive fertility cults focused upon the need to stimulate the god of procreation. The reasoning went something like this, according to Allegro. Since rain makes the crops grow, it must contain within it the seed of life. In human beings, this is spermatozoa, ejected from the penis at orgasm. Therefore, it followed that rain is simply heavenly semen, the all-powerful creator, God. The most forceful spurting of this seed is accompanied by thunder and the shrieking wind. This is the voice of God. Somewhere above the sky, a mighty penis reaches an orgasm that shakes the heavens. The lips of the penis tip, the glands open, and the divine seed shoots forth and is borne by the wind to earth. However, if the guy decided for some reason to withhold the seminal rain, life perished and there was nothing man could do. So for this reason, man became indebted to the god and needed to offer some reimbursement or sacrifice in atonement. It was important to keep the balance between giving and taking intact. Attention was eventually centered upon one particular plant that was seen to be more powerfully imbued with the god than any other, and whose sacrifice and consumption by an initiate was thought to restore any imbalance. In addition, consumption of this plant made possible a mystical unity with the god. This god expressed his seed from heaven, again, as a mighty penis ejaculating sperm at orgasm. It entered the womb of Mother Earth, and this gave rise to the bounty of the earth. Since the creative semen of the god was also the word, an initiate could acquire the knowledge of the god by partaking of the juice of certain plants, because vegetation was the fruit of God's union with the earth. The fertility deity appeared in all living beings, but in some more than in others. Those plants associated with the power to heal or kill then became the study among witch doctors, prophets, and priests of the ancient world. These individuals preserved the knowledge of the names of these plants along with how they should be used. One of the main reasons why the ancients considered the mushroom as one of the greatest marvels of nature was because they were not grown from seed, but could spring up and live without a root. The ancients did not understand the function of the spore, which is produced by the mushroom in the millions. Because to them, the mushroom had no seed in the accepted sense, the ancients saw the process of its growth as mysterious and mystical. In other words, the normal process of growth had been bypassed. The ancients believed that the god had spoken and his creative word had been carried to the earth. This divine union was thus seen as the Son of God, the Jesus born of the Virgin. In addition, the phallic form of the mushroom matched that of his father, whom the Sumerians called Iskor, or the mighty penis. Therefore, to see the mushroom was to see the father. Allegro quotes a Bible verse pertaining to this from John 14:9. He who has seen me has seen the Father. Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father in me? Thus, it was as the holy plant that the sacred fungus came to be known throughout the ancient world. The holy plant was believed to be endowed with divine knowledge and capable of healing sickness. Those who were rubbed with it could receive this divine knowledge and be cured. The principle behind this practice is that the god's seed of life, semen, found in spring or rainwater, in the sap or resins of plants and trees, and above all in the slimy mucus of the mushroom, is able to impart life to the ailing or to the dead. Things and people could thus be anointed with semen and become holy, that is, separated to the god's service. Allegro says that the Semitic root QDSH, holy, is, as its probable root meaning indicates, fundamentally a fertility word that has to do with the uterus, the holy of holies of the female, and the inner sanctuary of the temple. In addition, both the Semitic and the Greek words for Christ, the anointed or smeared one, came from Sumerian terms for semen. To summarize this first part of Allegro's book then, according to Allegro, in the phallic mushroom, the man-child born of the virgin womb, we have the reality behind the Christ figure of the New Testament. His thesis is that this Christ figure is representative of the initiatives and initiates of the mushroom cult, the Christians, or smeared with semen, as the name means. By imitating the mushroom, eating it, and sucking its juice or blood, the Christian was taking into himself his God and mystically involving himself in the creative process. In the language of the mystery cults, this means they were born again so they could once again reach their God in a drug-induced ecstasy.